The leader of Blackland First, BLF, Andile Mqidama, says even after 22 years of democracy, whites still own everything in South Africa and blacks own nothing. He further said whites use their economic power to buy politicians and what President Jacob Zuma removed as they don't have any control over him. He's now joining us in our studios here in Johannesburg. Andile, good morning to you and welcome to Morning Live.
Yes, good morning and good morning to the viewers.
Thank you so much for your time. How do you justify your statement that even after 22 years of democracy, whites still have everything and we don't have nothing?
From my own example, my own family, my community, but also we ask a very simple question. Just look at who owned the banks, who owned the mines, who owned Pep Store, who owns Checkers, who owns KFC. We as black people have nothing on our names. We have to go to white people for jobs. And even the JSE, if you look at it, only 3% of the JSE after 22 years is 3% is owned by black people. The same thing with the land question. Only 35,000 white families own 80% of South African land. We are a country of about 54 million people. The black majority remains marginalized and excluded. Go to university. Our students today are black students, are on strike, even burning down their own institutions because we have no means to get to university. Mm. That's why we make a serious call to the president. Say, we don't support the imperialist call for Zuma to go because we know that's white people, white business here and
abroad. But how do you know that it's the call by white people?
You know, Johan Rupert, our South African, one of the biggest business people, has come out and say Zuma must go and the Guptas must go. He has come out very openly. When you look at the appointment of the Minister of Economic, Minister of Finance, Pravin Gordhan, you will find behind that white people, as white business, as BLF, we have opened criminal cases. We know they met. They threatened the ANC. They said they want him. And the shocking thing we found lately is that, in fact, the same Minister of Finance has shares in the same companies of these guys. And over and above this, people like Johan Rupert, this big capitalist, have stolen from the Reserve Bank. We have another case we're following with the public protector, where 26 billion. I was arrested for going to the public protector's office to demand that she follows up on the 26 billion. We want that money. We know who stole it from the Reserve Bank, and it's money that can support the unemployed youth and support also the call for free education.
But then on the call for the president to step down, it's not just white people who are making this call. We've also seen black people making the very same call.
Yes. Just like in apartheid, there were black people who supported apartheid. But that was not our agenda. Mm. The homeland process was not our agenda, but black people were part of it. So similarly, if you look at Brazil, and for me, that was a big wake-up call. A democratically elected president has been removed by corrupt people, claiming that the president is corrupt. When that happened, we started to make connections. What is going on in the world today is that the BRICS countries are being attacked by the traditional Western imperialism of London, the US, and the EU. So we must be careful when we make the call, Zuma must go, because what all we're doing, we playing into an agenda which is not ours. We are not going to go back to that whole thing which we saw with Thabo Mbeki. He's being removed before his term. We spent so much time as black people fighting amongst ourselves about who must become the president, sponsored by white people, and we never go to fight the real battle of land and economic transformation. We are saying to President Zuma, hands off President Zuma, but we have clear demands. We are not just making that call. We're saying, bring the land of black people. Make sure we get our land back without paying. Make sure you break down the monopolies. In South Africa, few white companies are monopolies and they control everything. We say free education is very important. Mm-hmm. Marikana reparations and a minimum wage. Some of the things that we say, President Zuma, if you can resolve this, your legacy will be a different legacy. We want conversation with black people, including the ruling party. We are saying it is time, 22 years later, something has gone very wrong here and we must find solutions.
But are you saying, Andile, that we do not have any blacks in South Africa that are progressive?
Well, there are, myself included. Mm. And this call is supported by a lot of progressive black people. We have asked for money, by the way, donations. And we have seen some black people putting in 1,000 rand in our account, 500 rand, 200 rand to push this campaign.
So who are they? Are you able to name them?
No, I mean, there's just ordinary South Africans. Mm-hmm. And of course, we believe that once we have this money, we will publish the names of people who are giving us this support.
So what is happening now with your campaign? Are you going around South Africa to make this call? Do you have any information that you're disseminating among South Africans?
We are going to go into the media. We are going to put adverts. We're also going to pamphlet here. We're going to use this going to our communities, in the taxi ranks, in the shebeens. We're going to sit down in churches. We're going to say to our people, after 22 years, let us be careful. Politics are being used to divide us and to delay us. Let us move our focus away from Zuma and the Guptas and these small black people. Let us focus on the real enemy. In South Africa, the enemy remains white capital. It remains those who have our economy, who have our land, who have made sure that we're in squatter camps, we're in townships, we're excluded. We need to shift our focus again back to that. Because up to now, 22 years, we've been fighting these stupid political battles amongst ourselves.
So it's not about politics, it's about socioeconomic issues.
We have to go to socioeconomic issues and the historical injustices and fight racism and colonialism. Absolutely. We have to destroy this economy structure, build a new one which will benefit the black majority.
Well, Andile, I'm afraid that's all we have time for this morning, but thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. See me in the streets.
Thank you very much indeed. That's Andile Mkutama. He is the leader of Black Land First, PLF, talking to us about what he calls the socio-economic problems that are facing South Africa and the whites ruling South Africa, as he explained. Well, we're taking a break. Money Life continues after this.